the Fukushima nuclear plant is to build undersea tunnel to release the millions of tons of treated water from the nuclear power plant. Via RT, this is Unbended Reality, the Tokyo Electric Power Company TEPCO Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant, the operations of Japan's Fukushima nuclear plant have announced plans to build an undersea tunnel to facilitate the release of more than a million tons of treated waters from the site into the surrounding ocean. Now you can imagine what this means for the Pacific Ocean and the life of the ocean. The 1 kilometer long, 8 feet wide tunnel will run east from the water container tanks, that is to east, of course, towards the Pacific Ocean, at the nuclear plant into the Pacific Ocean, allowing roughly 1.27 million tons of treated water to be released into the sea. This is despite opposition from neighboring countries. So Japan is going to do it anyway. Japan insists that the water, which is said to be released in 2 years, is completely safe, having been thoroughly treated to remove radioactive particles. Well, if it's safe, why don't they use it to water their areas? Why don't they use it for whatever they need water for? Now, the containers, they said, include water that was used to cool down the nuclear power plant after it went into meltdown in the wake of the March 2011 tsunami, as well as rain and groundwater that subsequently seeped into it. The Tokyo Electric Power Company, TEPCO, is set to begin building the tunnel March 2020, pending feasibility studies and the relevant authorization from Japanese officials. Kindly support my Patreon account since YouTube has again demonetized my YouTube channel. The daily posts are 5 videos daily, and they are totally different from what I have on my YouTube channel. Thank you so much for your support and that you find all my content so interesting. You'll find the Patreon account details in the description box below. We know that Fukushima radiation has already caused tremendous damage to the fishing industry, all the way up to the Canadian and US West Coast. Now, neighboring countries and fishing communities have criticized the water release plan over safety fears and worry that it will undermine confidence in seafood caught in the surrounding waters. I, for one, since 2011, try not to buy Pacific fish for consumption. I just don't trust the Pacific water fish anymore. Now, TEPCO has pushed back against the concerns. They are arguing that this tunnel would alleviate those worries by preventing the risk of the treated water flowing back to the coast. The Fukushima plant's chief decommissioning officer, Akira Ona, stated that officials are ready to dispel concerns held by people involved in fisheries and other industries. Well, where is the UN in this? There are people that should come in and test the waters that Fukushima wants to release, to make sure that TEPCO is not lying. I would think that they're going, you know, they will be, they will not be telling the truth because they want to get rid of this water. Now, TEPCO has said that it will only proceed with the release if the move passes inspections by the International Atomic Energy Agency, which has previously defended their plan to build the tunnel to release the water. Japanese Prime Minister Yoshihide Suga described the planned release as an inevitable task at the culmination of the long decommissioning process designed to clear up the impact of the devastating tsunami that caused this Fukushima meltdown. The 2011 Tohoku earthquake and subsequent tsunami left nearly 20,000 people victims to it along Japanese Pacific coast. The natural disaster caused a meltdown at the Fukushima plant, resulting in the worst nuclear disaster since the 1986 Chernobyl incident, which was near Kiev, Ukraine, with the Japanese government maintaining an evacuation order on one of the towns affected until 2019, when 40% of Okuma residents were permitted to finally return home. Citizens from Futaba and a number of neighboring towns still face restrictions due to the contamination caused in that area. And this is on Unbended Reality from RT. Please leave your comments and thank you for your support.